drop a six, make me drip. Woo, for my dog, hit a lick. Woo, heavy cam with the click. Woo, juvenile off the mix. Ayy, break it down, make it dip. Ayy, off top, off the rip. Ayy,
shout out to Mo Boombox, you know what I'm saying? It's R Squiggly here, you know what I'm saying? No mid blunts in the set.
And this is the session at moboombox.com.
Hi everyone, welcome back to the session with MO Boombox. I am Bria.
And I am Dio. Welcome back. Buenas noches,
como esta?
We are back.
Back, baby. We are back with two special guests.
Not one, but two. Very, very, very special guests. We have Virginia's own Squiggly with an R. The blonde hair bandit in the building. And we have Norri Jane, a model and singer.
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Okay, model and singer. We're gonna be chopping it up with them today.
First things first, why were you on Jerry Springer?
Oh, wow. We coming hot and heavy. She like damn. Paparazzi with it. You're not TMZ, bro.
Alright, I'm just gonna give you just a quick summary. Nothing too major.
Okay? He was on Jerry Springer. No, he ain't nobody baby daddy.
Okay? Yeah, basically, I took the girl up there to break up with her through a song that I made.
I never should.
So it's called Lost in the Smoke, and that's where the whole brand itself, Lost in the Smoke.
When did this happen? When did you?
January 19th last year.
Oh my God! Yeah. You really went. I'm sorry if the girl watching. That's funny as a bitch.
If she watching this.
I mean, yeah. It was bad, but I mean, at the end of the day, you know, shit happens. It was cute. It was a cute experience.
So yeah, how was the experience? Like, how did you get on the show? Tell us. Like.
Basically,
she didn't swing on you.
She did.
Bro, can you watch that episode?
Like, isn't it like one of the top 10 Jerry Springer episodes all time or something like that?
It's number two.
Number two episode of Jerry Springer all time.
I don't know who got number one, but I know I got number two.
So the process, how did that go?
Basically, just quick rundown. I was at my brother's. He just had a baby at the hospital. My bro calls me and was like, "Hey man, you trying to go to Jerry?" I was like, "Fuck it." At the time, me and the girl was like in a rocky stage. I was trying to cut her off, but she was just like, "It's like you forcing a situation kind of turns you off." You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like guys be like, "Oh, I'm too nice to girls." Well, some girls don't want nice guys, and they kind of turn them off. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. After a while, but basically, she wanted something I didn't want it. So I was like, "Fuck it, I'll go." They started talking to us. They split us up. The way they interviewed us was just like everybody was. It was like on some secret shit. They would always make sure that we were never together.
Super secret.
On the phone.
Jay, explaining that's what I'm.
So then, and then I was like, you know what? I mean, for real, I really don't like the girl like that. I mean, I just break up with her.
Damn.
So
you didn't think it was messed up to break up with her on like national television, like.
No, what I thought was messed up.
And you singing her a song about breaking up with her. Like,
what I thought was messed up was a simple fact. The way they just boosted the situation, it was like, yeah, bro, you gonna sing this shit? You gonna look in her eyes?
The Jerry Springer production team.
Yeah,
and you was just like, yo, I'm trying to shout out my SoundCloud.
Yeah, I ain't really doing much. God. And then, you know, the whole situation happened. The only thing I was the most awkward was the ride back.
Y'all had to ride back together?
On the flight, we had three different seats. when we got to Norfolk Airport and we was driving home, not a word.
Oh my God.
Not even music. All we heard was tires on the street.
That's crazy.
For 30 minutes.
And y'all drove back to the crib together?
No. Yeah. She had her car at my crib, yeah.
And so you drove
her
back to the crib, bro?
Did she know she was going on Jerry Springer?
She knew she was going on Jerry Springer, but
she didn't know why.
She just agreed, like, yo, let's go on Jerry Springer. It can't be nothing bad. It can't be anything bad. Let's go on Jerry Springer, guys.
But, like, you know, if y'all want the clip of me getting slapped, it was bad.
You
know what I'm saying? She was from New Orleans. You feel me?
Niggas go on Jerry Springer and tell each other, like, be like, yo, I was born a man or some wild shit. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Not
like,
break up with like, somebody. Yeah, song.
Like, so she just expected, like, yo, he might propose to me or some dumb shit.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? That's crazy. If you watch it, I'm sorry.
If you watch the episode, you'll see the whole shenanigans. It was just too much, you know what I'm saying? But I got slapped.
That's crazy.
My homegirl got slapped. My homegirl got it bad, though, because it looked like she kissed her palm. It was a perfect lip imprint.
Why are your homegirl getting slapped?
And she smacked
it? She came on the show with me. Slapped the fuck out of her.
Damn.
Me, I mean, I took my shit like a man, you feel me? But, dog,
So what was backstage? Did you see that one tear? That one tear fall out of your eye? Yeah, she was hurt. You gotta chill, bro. It was an Indian tear. Yeah, that was it. Okay, that was that. So what you got going on? Missy just released a video. We did. I saw the video. That was dope. It was good. Yeah, we watched it together. As a matter of fact, it was dope. That was dope. So how was that process?
Johnny Creator reached out to me. I had an idea. We actually had no idea how we were gonna shoot or what we were gonna shoot. I just brought three outfits and I was like, what we gonna do? And the crazy thing was, in the studio, you can see in the video I got Tim's on. That was not planned at all. I had the gown and I had leggings underneath it and I was like, I can't. And it was where the studio was, it was like just wood.
I'm
like,
so glad you said that, because Dia was gonna bring that up.
My Tim?
I was gonna ask
you, why hate you had on that.
I was like, I seen the dress. I was like, okay, I see. You know what I'm saying?
It came together.
And then the zoom out. And then the zoom out, and I was like, is that him? Like, she got some butters on.
Thank you. Thank you. You're very welcome. What else you got coming up? I got a project, Soul Session, coming out the end of this month. Okay, a lot of new sounds, something I'm not used to. It's not the regular Norri Jane sound, so it's gonna be different. I haven't even like no sneak peeks, nothing, like no one's heard anything. Super secret, real Frank Ocean with it. Real Frank Ocean. So when you plan on releasing, you said? The end of this month, no release date yet. It's gonna be a real secret, but we know it's this month. So yeah, look out. Okay, we will definitely be on. Yeah, okay. So how do you feel like there's a lot of young women coming up out of Virginia right now, like Lecree and Vesta and yourself, so how does that feel like there's a resurgence of women's R&B music coming back to Virginia? How do you feel? You put yourself in there and that picture.
I'm not from here originally. I moved here 2 years ago. And I recently met Vesta and Cree. I'm mad cool with Cree, like that's my girl, that's like my sis.
And like, and we happen to be mixed with the same thing. We're both Thai and black, so like, like we have a lot in common. She comes over a lot, like, but I love it. We have like, I feel like with the women in this area, there's definitely a type of growing artistry within the women's culture here, and nothing I've ever experienced before. So I look forward to what's coming out of it too.
Do y'all plan on collabing, or is that a secret?
We do. It's kind of a secret, but everyone keeps everyone mentions that. Look out, look out, look out. We know it's coming. The streets need that.
So I'm gonna ask you the same thing, bro. How do you feel? I know you don't label yourself a rapper, even though you got bars like the Snickers Factory. You know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? I know you label yourself as more of a singer, alternative, I'm anything, but you know what I'm saying? So how do you feel with your lane, like where you're coming up at?
It's more competitive.
Because, you know, Norfolk, like, I feel like the 7-5, you know, we got IPM, we got Crazy Camp, all that. It's a lot of trap, like, trap-tastic. It's a lot of trap stuff. And you just kind of come with, like, a different vibe. Like,
is it harder for you because it's so much, you know?
Yeah, it is. Because we all, at the end of the day, we all in the same lane. You know what I'm saying? I could label myself as a singer, but the type of beats that I'm on, they'll still put me in the category of trap.
This man made a country beat, I'm not gonna lie. I watched him make a country beat in like 15 minutes sound like an alarm clock option on your phone. I'm not lying.
Dolly Parton could have hopped on that shit and turned into a hit. No bullshit. I'm a big fan of Dolly Parton, no bullshit. But basically, it's more competitive as far as, you know, just the music scene out here. But it's cute.
You still getting your attention though. Like, you finding your niche. Like, you open up for Lil Uzi.
Yeah.
You open up for Migos. Yeah. You know. So I mean, you doing your thing.
So how did you get on that? How was Uzi?
The Uzi show was really good. You know what I'm saying? It was here? I was at the Norva, and we were the last performer.
Me and him, true story, we were the last performers on stage before Uzi came out to perform.
Yo.
I jumped on stage and broke my leg.
How you gonna try to slide past we were the last performers?
hey, they don't believe me, bro. Okay, so look, I wrote a song for him that ended up being on the gluten-free tape. It's called UPS.
Yeah.
That shit slaps.
So you're a rapper?
I'm not a rapper. It was just something we did. Like, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
This is my brother. Like, Dio, you were a rapper? Or were you just a hype man? I was the hype man.
I was lit, though.
I'll tell you one thing.
I was throwing water on people and shit. I was that guy. that guy with Stone Cold with the water bottles. Yeah.
So yeah, the last song I was performing, we out there, we just chilling and shit. You know, it has a long ass intro, and I didn't even see Dio. You know what I'm saying?
Which song? Oh yeah.
So when I seen the actual clip, all I see is Dio just coming from the back, beat drop. You would thought this nigga was doing a lifesaver. You know what I'm saying? He baptized the whole front row. And everybody
got blessed. That was a great night. That was a great night, though. Shout out to Norma. Shout out to Lil Uzi and everybody
Creative
else.
Nation too.
Creative Nation, that was big. And we, you know what's crazy? We plotted on that. Like I said, we get Drew Casso and my man's Jave. We put together a mixtape in like 5 days before the concert. Yeah. It was a beautiful thing. Great. It was a great summer. But.
So how did y'all get on?
Money talks. Money talks, you know what I'm saying? Keep it a buck. Migos was 500, you know what I'm saying? The Uzi was 15, you know what I'm saying? Money didn't really bother me, you know what I'm saying? But I just put it up and just did it. I capitalized, at first, the Migos, I didn't capitalize how I did the Uzi concert, you know what I'm saying? But as far as people just recognize me off on the street, yeah. Mm-hmm. That was more so from the Uzi concert. People didn't even recognize me at first, cause especially from the Jerry Springer shit, because I dyed my hair blonde.
Mm-hmm.
Right before the Migos concert, 3 days before, I dyed my hair blonde. Got a nose piercing, did all that.
That's when the blonde hair bandit was born.
Yeah. And that was it.
What inspired the blonde hair? You just wanted something different?
It's cute as fuck. What you mean?
Alright, okay. He said it's cute as fuck.
It's cute as fuck.
So alright, with that, we're going to end. We're going to go to our first break here. Take a little music break. You know what I'm saying? It's the session. Spark something.
Spark something. I like that. It's cute.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't even understand how the fuck my plug talk. Pick him up in a space cool. I don't let my plug walk. Freak, I had to cut my other little bitch off. Ooh. 50K, you could come and book a nigga for a plug walk. You can reach me. Space coupe like E.T. It's the plug tryna call me. I was up chopping early in the morning. Ooh, on the wave like a durag. Pussy nigga calling for his boo bag. Plug walk, Gucci on my shoe rack. Walk up in the house till I ran into the plug. Till I ran into the mud. I done ran into some racks, I done ran into your girl. Why the plug show me love? I done came up from a dub. Plug walk. Plug. I don't even understand how the fuck my plug talk. Pick him up in a space coupe, I don't let my plug walk. New freak, I had to cut my other little bitch off. Hey, you could come and book a nigga.
I'm back over here. We back over here, and I got some shit to say. Happy birthday, Bob Marley.
And free meat.
Free meat. You know, Philly, y'all won the Super Bowl. Like, that Lombardi trophy is good enough to get Meek out. Like,
right.
Take it to the jail.
Oh,
science, swipe my nigga out. You know what I'm saying? Let him turn up in his little bike and shit. Like, all right. So yeah, okay, but we about to talk about some shit. We still have Squiggly with an R with us and Norri Jane. And we just about to talk about some topics, some trending topics, things is going on in the universe, trending topics and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So let's get into it. How did y'all feel about Culture 2? I'm going to start with you, Norri.
About Culture?
Culture 2. The Migos album. Migos dropped Culture 2. How'd you feel about it?
You want to slide past me? Because I have no listens.
You didn't listen to it?
No. I've been busy. I've been working.
I feel that.
You're only missing like maybe 6 new songs for real.
That joint with Drake, I'm not going to lie. That's like the first one I listened to. And then like I ain't listened to the couple more till like 2 days later. It's not really like.
I ain't going well.
It's not Culture. It's not the first one.
I listened to the whole 2 hours. I was only disappointed because out of the whole Migos, Takeoff is my favorite. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, of course. Takeoff is everybody's favorite, I feel like.
For real, that shit was too fucking long. 4 minute songs, too long.
Like, five minute songs.
Were unnecessary because exactly. Some of them sounded the same.
Why does Offset need a bridge after the second hook? Like, what's going on at that point? Like, what's it? And like,
you got a lot to say, apparently.
Ooh, it's only but so many ooh, I can take. You know what I'm saying? Like,
there was a song where Quavo said yeah for 2 minutes. But it was on rhythm though. I fuck with that.
Like I talk.
Yeah.
Damn, walk it like I talk it. Like, hold on.
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, yeah. I mean, they big on ad-libs, but I don't need a bridge of ad-libs between the same voices. I don't know. I fucks with it. I mean, there's a couple good songs, like I said.
I
it's Migos. It's gonna slap, like, It is what it is.
It's I don't want to hear another Migos song till next year, though. I put that on
that. That's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen, bro. I'm pretty sure they already got the next mixtape coming out next week.
Oh, yeah.
Take off dropping a mixtape.
Yeah, and they still just dropped the QVC joint, you know, Ice Tray and all that. Like, bro, so we got a lot more Migos coming.
We got a lot for 2019.
But let's continue. Let's move on.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so we're going to talk about the Grammys. You watch the Grammys?
I did.
You did
I'm
not?
I'm telling y'all, I'm working on myself right now. No television, just me, the paintbrush, and a microphone.
Okay. I applaud that, but I need you to check up on the Twitter moment section. So, you gotta get hit.
Read feeds real quick.
All right. Okay, so did you see, like, a couple of the winners or whatever?
Oh, yeah, I've seen highlights.
Okay. Did you watch the Grammys, or did you see the winners or whatever?
I was on the Twitter moments.
See, that's why I didn't watch it. I got shit to do too. But I had the follow update button, whatever, on Twitter or some timeline. So yeah, okay. So you think the Grammys got it right with who won?
Yeah.
Album of the year.
Yeah.
You think Bruno? Okay. Do you think Bruno Mars deserves? Yeah. Okay. You know, I'm gonna give my hood bias. Okay. Cause okay, Bruno Mars. Yes, it was a beautiful album. This, that, and the third. Versace on the floor. I don't give a fuck. Okay. Kendrick has been doing this since Good Kid, Mad City. He said, Kendrick pulled up with Good Kid, Mad City, said, here's an album. I put my heart and soul into it. It's great. The people fuck with it. All I want is a Grammy. Them niggas said, nah, Chief.
All right.
We good, bro.
All right. I give it to you.
You know what I'm saying? Then this nigga pulled up with To Pimp a Butterfly. He said, bro, I made a critically acclaimed black conscious album. I put my heart and soul into it. And the people fuck with it. We gonna be all right, my nigga.
We gonna be all right.
And the Grammy said, nah, bro. That's not it. Okay, so I know the Grammys is saying some bias.
I don't think that artists should hold the Grammys to such offense to them. Their albums are lit. They don't need that Grammy for us to, you know, compensate that shit. So let Bruno get his Grammy.
I feel like they jugged us though.
No, they didn't. Let Bruno get that Grammy because he won the hearts of both black people.
I didn't know Bruno was black.
I know Bruno's black, but does Bruno know Bruno's black?
Bruno knows he's black.
He think Teddy Pendergrass, Marvin Gaye, and a couple.
I mean,
other
I fuck with Bruno. It's just like, damn, Jay-Z had like,
oh hell,
this
no.
nigga Jay-Z had the hell TED no. talk on the Soul Sample,
that
bro.
That nigga already got 21 Grammys.
He don't need
one more, bro.
Bruno won
like 5 Grammys. It is what it is. I don't give a fuck. I mean, shout out to him. Shout out to Jay-Z. But Kendrick, I'm just saying, give Kendrick his goddamn Grammy, yo. Like, come on.
He can get his shit.
He won an album of the year before, though.
He hasn't won album of the year.
Yeah, he did. I think he won.
He might have won rap album of the year, but he hasn't won album of the year.
You're right.
But he's been nominated. Like,
but you gotta think though.
Every album he's put out has been nominated for album of the year, but he hasn't won.
That's cool. It's been nominated, but is it like hit?
And you look at the field.
That's what I'm saying. Bruno hit everybody. Black people, white people, Puerto Ricans.
Like I give it to him.
Bruno got the range.
Yeah,
Him and Bruno had 2017 on lock.
But Bruno just had it a little bit more.
Okay, so let's keep it moving. Let's talk about other things.
Yeah,
I'm not. I want to see the Academy. Okay, fuck everybody. I want to see the Academy let fucking Kendrick win a Grammy and invite Chief Keef, bro. Invite Chief Keef. BET, invite Chief Keef to the fucking hip hop awards and shit. Like, that's all you gotta do. Rest in peace, Fredo. On to the next topic, though. So, we're gonna talk about, the Super Bowl. Anybody but Brady, anybody but the Patriots. I'm getting sick of that shit. So, okay, and then we're gonna talk about the halftime show, too. My man is JT. He was out there with the. You didn't see the Prince tribute, bro? It was beautiful, man. He was out there. Man, they lit up the whole arena in like the city of like Minneapolis, like purple and shit. It was great.
Oh, wow.
Like, yeah, it was
YouTube,
really dope.
It's on YouTube. Right. Check it out.
Do that. But it was a great performance. Like, shout out to JT.
I heard he tried
to get Janet to come back.
What?
And like she said, hell no. she put out a statement. That's how you know it's serious.
I will not be performing for those inquiring.
That's real shit, though.
But no, let's talk about the game. Let's talk about the beauty of the game. In like a, I feel like the underdogs, you know, they really showed out. I'm a Steelers fan. I'm going to say that first and foremost. So, of course, I want to see the Patriots lose. But it was a good game. Brady really put his heart and soul into the game. You know, it's a good feeling to see Brady do everything that Brady can do, and it normally works out for him, but this time it didn't. And that's man.
So, all right, let me ask you something. Do you think the whole him kissing his son fucked his head up?
Bro, that's just weird. You know what they said it is?
11 Mississippis. That's a long ass time.
Tom Brady is a vampire. He's sucking the life out of his son, like, so he can stay young and keep playing football.
Oh my god!
Conspiracy theory. I believe it.
Like the Kardashian curse.
The Kardashian curse is real thing too.
Travis Scott is not making.
They said Bill Belichick has the Force like Darth Vader. So, I mean, I believe some shit's going on with the Patriots. They probably do got superpowers. Robert Kraft got laser eyes or something. But yeah, it was a good game. Shout out to the Eagles. Shout out to Philly. Y'all need to go break Meek out of jail with the Lombardi
right.
trophy.
I'm telling y'all,
just riot. Y'all can do it.
I ain't gonna. I'm not with the free Meek shit.
Why?
Because there's niggas in the system that did not have as much chances as Meek.
Yeah, but they not Meek.
I can't fuck with that.
But they not Meek.
Nah, I can't fuck with that. You had too many. That shows you that money really runs the whole, you know, locality of just law.
I see what you're saying.
But we knew that.
I'm Haitian as fuck.
I knew that.
Free Kodak, but at the end of the day, Kodak, you know better.
Meek is kind of like, okay, like, I mean, yeah, he might have violated, like, going out of state, but you don't got to throw my man's back in jail for, like, 4 years, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
After he just did a bid,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
That was his agreement with that.
Like, I mean, yeah, that's fucked up. Kodak out here, like raping white women and stuff, like, it's like, bro. They don't want to see you winning. You don't want to see you winning. You don't want to see you winning. Shit.
Get your shit together.
But all right, okay. So I heard you say something about Travis Scott. Let's talk about Kylie Jenner and Travis
cool.
Scott.
Yeah.
We already knew. Everybody and their mama knew Kylie Jenner was pregnant.
Yeah.
But then she said, "Hey, I had this baby," and everyone was like, "Oh my god!"
Everybody was crying. I ain't cry. I thought the video was beautiful. Don't get me wrong. But y'all extra as hell for crying. Like, come on.
Okay, but they said, okay. So this is what I put together from Twitter or whatever. You know, I just be scrolling and shit. So they said, remember Travis Scott dropped Butterfly Effect.
Everybody said the name of her baby.
He dropped that shit 9 months ago, and they named their baby like Mariposa or something like that.
No, the name of her baby is Stormy.
Oh, I heard some Mariposa shit or something. They said that's Butterfly.
We both
heard that. That's what I see on Twitter. They said
Stormy,
they named it like Butterfly in Spanish.
Stormy
with an
I.
Oh, well, that's cool. That's even better. Stormy.
Yeah, that's dope. Stormy
that
Scott.
Like, that sounds like some Travis Scott shit. That sounds like a mixtape. Like
Stormy Scott.
Stormy Scott. You know his actual name is like Webster or something. So
yes. Yeah,
what's his last name? Scott.
No, his real last. His name's like Jack Webster.
Webster.
Yeah, Travis Scott.
So that's where Jack came from, Huncho Jack. Stormy Webster? No, it'll be Kardashian, because it'll be smart from the Jenner.
She's a Jenner.
She's a Jenner.
See,
that's how you...
Same DNA, same vagina she came out of.
It's all the same thing.
Okay. So that's the oh man, I would be politically correct. So...
Okay.
The
Kardashian curse is real.
Yeah.
Okay, Kanye dyed his hair blonde and set up a meme with Donald
Trump.
Hey,
we're not putting Kanye in this.
It happened. We're good now. Okay? Then Tristan Thompson started hitting Khloe. Man got out-rebounded by Steph in a 6 or 5 game series. In a 5 game series, this man, Steph Curry, had like 35 rebounds. Tristan Thompson had like 12. Okay? Like, come on, bro. That man's 6'3 and you're 7 foot. Well, that's all you do. Like,
right.
The Kardashian curse is a real thing.
Yeah.
Travis Scott's my man's. I went to his concert last year and raged my life away all night in Portsmouth. And, you know, I want to see him do great things. Astroworld's going to be amazing. Huncho Jack is pretty cool.
Yeah.
So I hope he doesn't get hit with the Kardashian curse.
He already did. He had a baby with him. Cause you know, Tyga got hit.
And you know, he hit Kendall first too. That's the crazy part.
He hit Kendall?
When him and Kylie broke up, it was because he told Kylie that Kendall was better. Yeah.
Oh.
You ain't know that, did you?
Oh.
on the session.
Well, now we know.
Next topic.
That was a hot one.
Oh, yeah. And on a hot note, you know what I'm saying? Dio got the sauce. let's go to the next topic. Let's talk about XXL freshman list. I don't even know what the fuck
that was.
You know,
what the fuck was that? That was a disgrace.
I mean, they got
exactly.
the list of people.
Yeah.
I don't know if the actual list is out, but you know, people have been talking and who's been hot in the year and shit. So, like, I just want to say, I remember back in the day, the XXL Cypher, like 2012, it was Meek, it was Wiz, they had J. Cole up there, Big Sean, you know what I'm saying? Like, Real Chance was up there a couple years ago with Nick Mensa, Kendrick.
And Lil B dropped the hottest bars.
Lil B, like, even, like, they had a whole bunch of Mac Miller, everybody was on the XXL Cypher. It used to be hot, like, straight bars.
Fire, but now,
and now it's like... Once they, I feel like it was Lil Yachty. I'm not gonna say it. I feel like it was Lil Yachty. Once he got up there, yeah, it was like
went down.
You asked certain niggas to freestyle. Okay, like
wait, why? Who was before the Yachty that class? Who was before them?
2015 or well that was 2017, 2016.
Was it that wasn't Big? No.
That wasn't Big Sean. That was it Chance? That might have been the Chance.
No, that wasn't Chance.
That was 2015.
I know Kevin Gates was.
Kevin Gates was on one year. He was yeah.
Yeah.
Hmm. I don't know, but still, it wasn't
that's
a trash.
Trash it is, because
I see, okay, I fuck with some of the new young niggas. I'm not gonna say like everybody trash. I fuck with Trippie Redd. Damn, that's about it. I fuck with Trippie Redd. I fuck with
none of them.
Lil Pump, yeah, Lil, he gonna make the list because the Gucci Gang shit, but he. Just
that's
bro. He's like, he's just like the one with bubblegum dreads. That's how I address them. Like, that's the one with the pink dreads. Like, I feel racist when I talk about new young niggas. I'd be like, get the little nigga with the red dreads. Like, you know what I'm saying? I like that song about little nigga with the red dreads.
So, you got Lil Pump
are going to
be
a They said YBN Namir. I fuck with that song. Yeah, he got the rubbing off the paint that joint. That was a bop.
Who else?
I can't even name.
Lil Skies might be up there. That, he came out of nowhere.
Who? They said Lil Xan. The Tekashi 6ix9ine rape nigga. I don't know.
He's not going to be up there.
Yeah.
Nobody's trying to attach his name.
He just got signed by Birdman, bro. They said Birdman running the gay blood click. Oh, man. He wasn't.
We got it.
Breaking news.
He wasn't
signed by Birdman. Yeah, it was just an Instagram photo.
Yeah, that was just bullshit.
Yeah, but they still said Birdman trying to set up a gay blood click.
I mean...
I wouldn't be surprised.
Someone need a G-check.
Just make sure Lil Wayne get paid.
Right, free the Carter 6. Fuck these niggas.
Carter 5.
Oh, Carter.
You ahead of your time already.
It's the 5?
Yeah, the 5.
Damn, yeah, that's right. It was dedication six. That's right. Okay. Was that?
I give it a thumbs up.
Okay. Yeah, dedication 6 was like
that.
The Family Feud joint with him and Drake, it was like that. It was like that. Okay, but let's go on to this last topic. Because the coach over there throwing up hand signs.
You telling us it's time to go.
Okay, so recently, I guess there's been a debate on Twitter, banter back and forth between fellows on Twitter, comparing Virginia's rap scene to the rap scene of Atlanta, or trying to be like it. And I know you have a strong point about this. I want to hear your point about this. You know what I'm saying? We're
going to
give our points about this, so let's talk about this. How do you feel?
As far as rap goes, I feel like there's no comparison. Atlanta's going to be Atlanta and Virginia's going to be Virginia. There may be some type of comparison people can draw because there's trending, you know, things that are going on within the rap industry. But I don't think there's no type of comparison. As far as I know, like, you can't compare this.
I agree with you.
What Virginia lacks that Atlanta has is that Atlanta's about to get into the bag. Virginia niggas, everybody wants to be honcho. Everybody wants to be the top dog. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, they have so much unity. You know, if you watch Migos' interview, just in general, QC, we'll just take QC for example. Everybody on that roster except one guy is from Atlanta. Everything they do is in-house. They got hella studios, hella labels in Atlanta. Plus, Atlanta got more money than Virginia niggas, period.
That's true.
So we just can't have no unity out here, you know what I'm saying? Because everybody's too cliquish.
I feel that.
I'm going to piggyback off of that and say the same thing. You know, it's not necessarily about getting to the bag. It's more like, most of the people in Atlanta are family. Like, a lot of the people that are hot right now, like Migos, like, I knew Migos went to high school with, like, OG Mako or some shit. And, like, you know, they got those relationships. Like, they all came up together. So it's more like family. Then you got your old heads out there, like Gucci, Coach K, all them rounding them up and just kind of keeping them together. Like, you know what I'm saying? So Atlanta's more about that family. We don't have that unity here in Virginia, you know what I'm saying? Pharrell ain't out here with a local rap group.
Yeah.
Or Push It. I mean, Push out here, he's trying to, like, help some young niggas. But
Virginia niggas don't help each other.
Young Money on, not it. I said that.
You got to get shot for it.
Like Pusha T, like, he ain't out here setting up no rap clique, nothing like that. So, I mean, it's more about the family down there. Like, I feel that. That's why we can't prosper in Virginia.
Yeah, because he's too busy.
I don't want to cut y'all off. But I'm pretty sure everybody follows Say Cheese, right? Say Cheese posted had a post where it said Pusha T just signed a Chicago rapper. And I posted on my Instagram and I was pissed as fuck. You know what I'm saying? I said, yeah, you a legend and shit, but do something for the home team. You feel me?
Chicago gonna eat. They got the same thing, kind of like Atlanta up there, but they more like about their gang shit, you know what I'm saying? So it's like they stay together, but they get it up there too. Like, we need our own shit.
They move together. Virginia doesn't move together.
Like, everybody that made it out of Virginia, they kind of pop, and they kind of, I don't want to say they left, but they blow up somewhere else. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Push
with
Kanye. Nobody blows up in Virginia.
Pharrell went to New York and linked up with Hope and everybody.
They all grew up in Virginia.
On your Bow Wow shit, like, with Bow Wow, like, these kids, no, no, I'm right behind them.
Ain't nobody give a fuck.
Oh my god.
I feel like give us one more year and then we'll be out.
Alright.
As far as everything.
Alright, so
Virginia is gonna be on the way up. I will end up.
We're on the come up, and it's not just music. We got artists, we got
fashion
dancers, fashion, clothing lines, we got hats, we got everything.
See, the thing is, everybody needs to stop being against each other and so much, move and competing together. Stop doing it together. What's wrong with doing it together?
Nothing.
I feel like
there's no one person doing
still from Virginia. I my Lost in the Smoke shit went viral. The High Def niggas, they just went viral, but they gonna go global with that little
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised if they actually bring more attention to Virginia niggas.
I feel like Virginia has potential to have a lot of attention. It's just we don't move the way we should, I feel like. But that's that.
I thought Virginia was going to blow up off the sauce walk. I ain't going to lie. Let's just end with that. Let's end the show. Hey, play the sauce walk at the end of the shit too. I don't know the dance either. We're not actually gonna sauce walk. It's been a session. We appreciate Miss Norri Jane with her fire sunglasses coming through. Yes. And the blonde hair bandit coming through. Little text alert. And Bria, I appreciate Bria for being Bria.
Dio.
Hey, that's my man's. It's been the session. No mid blunts, spark something, no bony tonies.
See ya.
I'm out.